You might have noticed the timer hardly changed at all between when I finished that last lecture and then now starting this one. And that's because I took a quick break while the video was rendering. When I'm able to take breaks easily, then the work I do is more effective. With just 4 hours to work, it's really easy to get adequate breaks in because then there's plenty of other time for breaks. So I can actually have a 5 or 6 hour period to work in, and then I only do about 4 hours of actual work. I take 10, 20, 30 minute breaks. I go to lunch. I go have a little snack. I walk the dogs. There's lots of time to take breaks when you're only aiming to get 4 hours of real work. So in terms of definition, what I'm meaning to get done is 4 hours of real work. Now, if you look at how people often end up working at a corporate office setting, they're lucky to get 1 to 2 hours of real work done every day. So what I'm saying with 4 hours of actual work every day, in a context of where normally things are filled up with all kinds of distractions and breaks and non-work activities like messing around on Facebook or something, I'm talking about 4 hours of real work every day, not counting breaks, not counting things that aren't work-related. And that includes meetings, though. That includes talking with people. So this motivates me to take good care of myself. It gives me the chance in that graph I showed you about self-care. When I only work 4 hours each day of actual time, then there's plenty of time for self-care. And self-care is incredibly important to doing your best work. And I mean real self-care, not punishing myself with a workout that's really difficult or with a bunch of alcohol or other substances or with a bunch of video games to the point where I can't even see anymore. Really doing self-care, like I just went and had a banana and drank some water and walked around. I mean, that's real self-care, rejuvenation. So I'm grateful that the way I work now, there's plenty of time for breaks.